In this video, I'm going to explain the information that you get back from a call to the Microsoft Cognitive API. The information is returned as JSON, and I'll help you to identify the important fields that you'll need to interpret in order to play the match game. Let's have a look at that now. In order to work with the Microsoft Cognitive API, we need to generate an API key for the services that we want to access. Microsoft have cognitive API services for vision, speech, language, knowledge, and search. For our match game, we'll use the vision service, and we need to create a computer vision API key. Microsoft's computer vision API lets us analyze an image to discover information about its visual content. It can read text in images, and it can read handwritten text. It can recognize celebrity faces, and it can recognize landmarks from around the world. It can also analyze video by extracting frames and analyzing them with the other computer vision services. We are going to introduce you to this powerful computer vision API in order to play our match game. In the game, you will have to analyze the images on our tiles and match images that have the same type of content. To do this, we first need a key for the computer vision service. You need to sign up for an Azure account. Students get a free trial with $100 credit by signing up at aka.ms/Azure for students. There are instructions on how to do this at help.aigaming.com, and your local Microsoft student partner should be able to help you if you have any problems. When you've logged in to your Azure account, choose the option to create a resource. Select AI plus machine learning, and then computer vision. Give your key a memorable name. The name cannot have any spaces and should only be alphanumeric characters. Use AI Gaming Match Game. Under subscription, you will have some different options from us. You will have the option of free trial. Select the free trial option. The location you choose is very important. Our example code uses the West Europe location, so choose the West Europe location when you create a key. Choose S1 10 calls per second as your pricing tier. This uses the credit from your free trial, as it is the paid level of access to the API. You need this speed of access in order to compete with other people when playing the match game competitively. The F0 20 calls per minute, 5k calls per month pricing tier is a free access tier if you are experimenting with new services and don't want to incur costs or use up your free credit. And finally, you can add your resource to a group if you have many different services and you need to group them together to keep track of them. Use the Create New option to create a new group. Call it AI Gaming and then select it in this dropdown. Click the Create button to create this service. Now, if you click on the Cognitive Services icon from your home page, you will see a list of all of the services you've created. If you click on the AI Gaming Match Game service we just created, you will see an option to grab your keys. Click on the keys link and you will be shown two API keys. You can use either of these keys. They both work in the same way. Copy one of the keys and go back to the AI Gaming site. If you go to the editor on the AI Gaming site and choose the match game game type, then load the MS API template code, you can see the comment that tells you to get a Microsoft API key. Paste your new API key where it says your Microsoft Computer Vision API key here. You can now run this template code and it will analyze images to see if they have animals in them. We can see that there is a lot of information being displayed in the information column of the editor. Let's add the response from the Microsoft API call to this information. If we search for the phrase animal colon in the code, we can see where we print out information when we have found an animal in an image. Let's add a new line to print out the MSAPI response so that we can see all of the information that we received from the computer vision API call. Let's run the game again and have a look at the results. Now we can search through the output for ** API, and we can see all of the information received from the API call. We can read through it here or copy it out to a new file so that we can get a clearer view of it. And now we have a clear view of all of the information returned from the Microsoft Cognitive API. We can use this view of the information to determine which fields are useful to us and how to access them in our code. That's it for our introduction to viewing the Cognitive API responses. There are more videos in this series, so please make sure to check them out. Thank you.